I'm standing on the Western States Trail. About 3 miles that way is Auburn, California. About 97 miles that way is Squaw Valley. On the last weekend of every June, a group of people gather to run that entire distance. If they do it in under 24 hours, they get a silver belt buckle. A belt buckle. That's all. No fame, no glory. They probably won't even get their picture in a magazine or newspaper. But that belt buckle represents their passion, and that's what it's all about. Sure, covering 100 miles by foot is no easy task, especially in these mountains. But it's not a new challenge. Over a century ago was the age of pedestrianism, and it was as much of a trend back then as jogging is today. This trail is in better shape than roads they would travel back then. A paved road was very uncommon, and sidewalks were virtually unheard of. But instead of running these great distances, back then, people would walk. History has many stories of pedestrians covering 100 miles in under 24 hours, dating back to the late 1700s. Often walks of 50 or more miles in a day would be part of a much greater mileage. 500 miles, 1200 miles, even over 2000 miles covered in a period of over weeks or months turned the more passionate pedestrians into huge celebrities. The granddaddy of pedestrian celebrities was Captain Barkley, and one of his famous challenges was also the most profitable for any athlete up until that point in history. Wagering on pedestrians was probably more popular than the sport itself, and Captain Barkley's $10,000 purse was to be the biggest yet, even for decades after his victory. What did he do to cash in? He walked 1,000 miles. But it wasn't the distance that was impressive, it was the time frame. He walked 1 mile every hour for 1,000 hours straight. Now he was capable of a 6-minute mile, but that is still over a month of not having more than an hour and 48 minutes of uninterrupted sleep. Whew! On his last hour for his last mile, there were thousands of folks in attendance to watch. Probably the most famous of all the great walkers was Edward Payson Weston. Weston the Pedestrian, as he was known, started his path, so to speak, after losing a bet. Due to Abraham Lincoln winning the election, Weston had to walk 478 miles in 10 days to get to Lincoln's inauguration. Well, he missed the inauguration, and he lost the bet, but only by a bit, and he went on to dance at the inaugural ball that evening. He did not lose much after that, though. In 1874, he walked 500 miles, in just under 6 days, the first 115 miles of it in 24 hours. Even while walking some of it backwards, he once covered 200 miles in 41 hours. Weston didn't let age slow him down. He celebrated his 70th birthday by walking from New York to San Francisco, covering a 4,000 mile route in under 100 days, and that was with Sundays off for church. So you gotta be wondering, what did he eat?
The stomachs that can't digest ordinary food are those that are spoiled by high living or no exercise.
Weston would often eat 18 eggs, each beaten up in a pint of milk with a tablespoon of sugar. It was the equivalent of the modern protein smoothie. He wasn't afraid of pie or griddle cakes or pudding either, and he would often eat while he was walking. Unfortunately, the man who argued against the popularity of automobiles, he claimed they made us lazy, was hit by a taxi in New York City, injuring him enough to curtail his walking during the last 2 years of his life. During this life, he was a celebrity, a huge sports star. Thousands of people would show up to celebrate his destinations, and children would mention him in their diaries when he walked through their towns. I wonder how he would have done on this mountainous Western States trail.
Power walk!